Yeah.
Do you know where we are?
An air-conditioned lift.
An air-conditioned lift? Mike, are you a tech or what? Okay, then clue number 80.
Mary, look, this is ridiculous. You know, I'm just out of here. This is so stupid, your game.
Mind the shape!
Oh, well done. Eyes. Isn't he looking a lot better?
Yeah.
There you are. Sorry to squash you, but you're free to go. Oh. Well, welcome to the works. It's good to be back. So what's on the show this week? Well, we're going to be doing a fix-it for somebody, answering some of your questions, and having a brilliant studio competition, which, as always, will be made up of skill and knowledge games over a number of challenging rounds. So how's it won? Well, at the end of each game, precious iotas are awarded, and the team with the most iotas at the end of the show wins. But what do they win? Let's take a look at the prizes. The runners-up will get a selection of Waddington board games, and the winners will receive from Philips a compact disc interactive machine, television set, and some CDI discs. And with this machine, you can access information both in sound and vision. You can even play games and normal CDs on it.
Teams of 1993. The red team are from Coot Hill in County Cavan, and the green team are from Wedgwood in Dublin. And on the red team we have Leisha, Ruth Ann, Aidan and Shane. And what school do you go to?
St. Michael's Senior National School.
Okay, and tell us about your school.
Well, it's in the senior school there's 7 teachers and 168 pupils on roll.
Okay, and what sports do you do?
Well, the boys have a football team, but they weren't very successful this year.
So the boys aren't any good, I see. And you've also got junior wardens, haven't you?
Yeah.
Are you one of them?
Yes.
What do you get up to?
Well, it's good enough, and then we have a tour at the end of the year and a competition.
Okay, and do you miss the day of school?
Yeah.
You go on that tour? Well done.
Yeah.
Okay, then, do you want to give a wave to all the Jordans, the junior wardens who are left behind?
Yeah, and all the other people that were left behind.
And anybody else?
And my family.
Okay, into that camera there, give them all a wave. Okay, then what's your motto for today? They're red, they're lead, and Wedgwood are dead. So let's go over and meet Wedgwood. And representing Wedgwood are Neil, Jennifer, Peter and Owen. And what school do you go to?
Queen of Angels.
And tell us about your school.
There are about 410 pupils in it, 15 teachers. We do basketball and Gaelic.
Yeah. And do you want to wave at those teachers?
I'd like to wave at Owen McCarthy and Kevin Buran.
Who are they now?
They're both senior footballers.
Oh, right. And are they? What age are they?
12.
They're in your class, are they?
No, they're in 6.
Oh, right. Well, give them a wave. So, do they ask you to give them a wave? Did they?
Yes.
Okay, right then. Everybody give them a wave into that camera there. Okay, then what is the Greens' motto for today?
We're green, we're mean, we're going to slaughter the Cavan team.
They're green, they're mean, and they're going to slaughter the Cavan team. Okay, then everybody give yourselves a big, huge cheer. Niall, you know at home those magnets that you have sticking messages to your fridge. Well, do you know, how do they work?
No.
Well, what does a magnet do you know?
It attracts metal.
But you don't know how it works?
No.
A magnet is a thing which attracts certain metals. It's a bit like me, really. Attracts some things and repels others. But all you science fans out there, did you know that the Earth is a huge natural magnet? Invisible lines of magnetic force spread out from the North and South Pole and encircle the whole globe. This is called the Earth's magnetic field. But when was magnetism first discovered? Well, years ago, people noticed that a certain type of iron ore called lodestone, when suspended from a string, would always point to the North. Another name for lodestone is magnetite, hence the phrase magnetism. So, magnets attract certain metals in the same way that beautiful women are attracted to me. Opposites attract, therefore Olivia was repulsed by me because we must have the same electrical charge. I guess you could call it animal magnetism.
Okay, it's time for round one of our studio competition. Now, this is the quiz. The whole idea is to move as far along the board by answering questions correctly. The teams have 2.5 minutes, and this week's specialist subject is plant life. Okay, let's see who goes first. I have here the colour coin. Will it be reds? Will it be greens? We'll soon see. It is a definite advantage. It is the green team!
Yeah!
Okay, two dudes for the green team. We've Owen and Peter. Okay, and your time starts now. What part of a plant is responsible for making food?
Roots.
I'm sorry, it's actually the leaf. Hard luck on that one.
Okay, then Ruth, Anne and Aidan from Cootal and County Cavan, your first question. What do you call the part of a plant that anchors it in the ground?
The roots.
Correct, except for one.
Okay, Owen and Peter, what tree produces nuts called acorns?
Oak.
That's correct. Take a step forward.
Okay, then Ruth, Anne and Aidan, what prickly desert plant stores water in its stem?
Cactus.
Correct. Take a step forward.
Okay, Owen and Peter, seaweed can live in all ocean levels. True or false?
True.
False. They can't live there. Deep down, there's no light down there.
Okay, Ruth, Anne and Aidan, plants use oxygen. True or false?
False.
It's true. Stay where you are.
Okay, identify this plant. What do you think that is?
Lily.
What type of lily? Have to hurry you.
Water
lily. Water lily's correct. Take a step forward.
Okay, then Ruth, Anne and Aidan, look at your monitor. Identify this plant.
Sunflower.
Sunflower, correct. Take a step forward.
Okay, no clues from the audience. Owen and Peter, plants need sap, sunlight or pollen to make food.
Sunlight.
That's correct, they need sunlight.
Yeah! Okay, then Ruth and Nate, you've got a choice, right? Deciduous trees have A, prickly spines instead of leaves, B, lose their leaves in winter, or C, keep most of their leaves in winter.
B.
Which is they lose most of their leaves in winter. Correct, take a step forward.
Okay, Owen and Peter, by studying the growth rings on trees, it is possible to find out about weather and pollution that occurred in the past. What else can you tell from growth rings on trees?
Oh dear.
That's correct. Take a step forward.
Okay, if you get this right, you're laughing. Okay, you've won. So, what leaf is well known for helping to soothe nettle stings?
Dockin.
No, yeah! No. Wait, what is it?
Docking leaf.
The dock leaf it is.
Docking.
Is that correct, Michael?
That's
I think we have to give them that. Take a step forward.
Okay,
red.
Then you got it.
Okay. A bit of controversy there, but the Reds have won round one of the quiz. So 2 out to the Reds, 1 to the Greens.
Yeah! How do turtles go to the toilet? In the water.
We went to the aquarium in Bray to find out. This is Leonardo. He is a very rare Kemp's Ridley turtle. He swam all the way from the Gulf of Mexico and ended up on the shores of Kerry. This is Connor the crab from Hoth. We waited and watched, and we didn't see any evidence, but Dr. Mike Connolly assures us that yes, turtles go to the toilet in the water. After a rest in Bray, Leonardo will be flown home to Mexico.
What I want to know is why do babes cry and where do tears come from?
Babies cry instinctively. Crying is a survival mechanism, a warning something is wrong. Babies cry when they're hungry, hurt, overtired, when their nappies need changing, or when they need a hug. Tears are produced by the lacrimal glands in the eye. Eventually, the baby grows up and can communicate through speech. But human beings cry when they are upset throughout their lives. Nobody knows why.
Okay, Mary, just relax.
Michael,
I know what I'm doing.
Are you sure you know what you're doing? I don't feel good about this.
I didn't spend 10 years studying to be a surgeon.
You spent 10 years studying to be a surgeon?
No, I just said I didn't spend 10 years studying to be a surgeon. Anyway, Mary, listen, your body is, it's great. When it all works so well, it's because of all the organs in your body. Now, you've got loads in here. You've got some great ones. Like, you've got your intestines. Look at those. Oh, they're great. You've got about 20 foot of those. You've got your lungs that help you to breathe. Muscles. Maybe next week. Kidneys. That's great. And best of all, my favorite is the old heart. Mary, did you know? Just an interesting fact. Pay attention. That your heart pumps 11 pints of blood a minute. That's 15,840 pints in 24 hours. Isn't that interesting? That's the same weight as a double-decker bus. Mary, you're grand. But the favourite organ of all is this one.
What organ is that, Michael?
That's just your little organ. Okay, suit yourself. There you are, Mary. You're looking great.
Michael?
Yes.
I demand to be put back together this minute.
Slight problem with that, Mary.
What?
I don't really know how to do it, but I think I know two people who do. Hang on a sec.
Michael, get back here now!
Hi, Shane, are you a surgeon?
Yeah.
Alicia, you a surgeon?
Yeah.
Okay, walk this way. I've got a job for you. Come on, this way.
Michael, I just want you to know I didn't want to play this game, but now that I am playing it, I'm ahead.
Oh.
Do you get it? I'm ahead.
That's very bad.
Yeah.
Okay, it's time for round two of our studio competition. As you can see, poor old Mary's looking a bit dodgy. How are you feeling, Mary?
Worried.
Worried not to worry, because we have her organs laid out here. And we've got two of the best nose, throat, school bag, diddly eye teacher specialists in the country. We've Dr. Shane and Dr. Alicia, who are going to put you back together again. And on their side of the board, they have a number of organs, which you can see there. You have got 30 seconds to place those in the right position on Mary. Okay, you all set? Your time starts now. Give them a cheer, Reds.
Have you guys done this before, have you? No.
Mary, I've got some bad news and good news.
What's the good news?
You've got 24 hours to live.
What's the bad news?
I should have told you yesterday.
Okay. Doctor.
Yes.
I feel like a spoon.
You feel like a spoon? Just don't stir. Are you sure that's right? Okay. 30 seconds up. And we ran out of cheering as well. Okay, let's see how they did. Okay, let's take a look. Lungs, they're in the right position. Heart was looking at, well, we'll give them that. It should have really been over a bit more. That's two. Their kidneys. That's right. Spleen is in the wrong spot. And let's take a look at the bones. We have the humerus and the radius, which is correct, which gives you a total of 5 for the Reds. Yeah! Okay. Thanks, Shane and Alicia. Let's get the Greens in. Come on in. We've got Niall and Jennifer for the Greens, okay? And I believe, Niall, your speciality is funny bones, but we don't have any of these here. You've got 30 seconds to put these organs on Mary's body correctly. Your time starts now.
Do the best you can.
Okay, there's the tibia, the appendix, the femur, the liver, the esophagus, and the stomach.
Oh.
Let's see how they do. It's
You've
a tough job.
Have you? Have you?
Yes, they're looking good. Some more support.
Michael.
Yes?
Got another joke.
Okay, what's the joke?
Last night I dreamt I was a wigwam, then a family tent.
You know what your trouble is? You're too tense.
Joke
now. Okay, time's up. Back to your position. Let's take a look and see how our young doctors did. Yes, that's right. That's the esophagus. That's sort of where you swallow and all that sort of thing. Let's take a look. We've got the appendix down here. Well, it's a bit less, but it's roughly in the right direction. That's two. We've got the liver here, which is right. It's three. That's actually the largest organ in your body. Stomach is looking a bit upside down, but it's in the right area, so that's four. Let's take a look at the bones. Yes, we have the femur and the tibia. Now they're looking good. They're the right way around? Yes, they are. So it's 2 points there as well, which gives them a total of 6 for the Greens. Okay, which means that the Greens win round two of our studio competition. So it's 2 iotas to the Greens, 1 to the Reds.
Yeah! Okay, then well done, the Greens. Now, do you remember before Christmas we surprised Carl Fahey? Carl Fahey wrote into us and he wanted to find out how come a big steel ship can float and stones sink. Well, we brought him off sailing on the Askard and this is what he found out. Right. And do you know the way I'm from Cork, right?
Yeah.
And where's Cork near? It's near the sea. And my cousin's name is Arthur Mead. And thousands of years ago, right, he sailed off on a ship one time and he went all the way to Greece. And when he got to Greece, they renamed him Archimedes, right? And he used to hang out in pools and baths a lot. And he used to know all about floating and buoyancy and displacement. He had a handle on it all. Are you even listening to this, are you?
Yes.
Listen up. His name was Archimedes, and he was really cool. He came from ancient Greece, and he was no fool. Now he loved science, and science loved him. He got crazy principles, that's why we praise him. He jumped into the bath to have a little swim. Some water splashed out, and he began to think.
This is so confusing. I'm feeling kind of tense. I'm not stupid, but eureka, I'm dense.
Now the water he spilled, he exactly worked out. You see, his volume was the same as the water he splashed out.
All hands aloft to break out the square cells. Hands aloft. Come on, let's go.
Asgard 2 is a sail training ship. It's mainly for young people from 16 to 25. You're probably a little bit young yet. For them to come here and have the experience of walking and living together, learning some sailing, learning some seamanship. And after they get used to things on board here, enjoying themselves, having a lot of fun, and usually having a good adventure as well.
Come on, a bit of effort.
Hey, Carl, this is the fourth staysail halyard. I'm going to make it up on the fin now. So remember what you did before. If you take a turn around the bottom, that's it, around the top. Okay, now figure of eights. Okay, now you can let go with this hand and just use the other hand, two hands together to make it all the way up. Okay.
How do boats stay afloat?
It basically stays afloat because it's hollow. If you can imagine a cup floating on top of a sink of water at home, the cup will float because it's hollow, because it has air inside in it. If it had something heavier inside in it, it would sink. So the volume of the cup filled with light air keeps it afloat.
Air's a great thing, it can help things float. So trap air inside and it'll be like a boat. Hey, don't push things under that don't want to go. You'll find great resistance, so lessen the air flow.
Hi, Tom.
Hi, Mary. How are you?
The sea's beautiful, isn't it?
I'm glad. Nice and bright.
I live down by the sea in Cork. You're from Cork as well, aren't you?
I am. Sure, aren't some of the best sailors in the world from Cork, sure.
Like who?
There was a case there. Some time back, a fella called Arthur Mead. He left from Inchidani in West Cork, and he went out to Greece, and she didn't call him Archimedes when he got out there.
Sure, I know. On my mum's side, back to Connolly's, I'm related to the Meads.
Sure. And my own mother's side, aren't I, related to Columbus?
No.
That's true. What way? Judge, yeah. He was related back down the line there, and that's
so you have to be very careful, you know, you have a very responsible job here. Now, in front of you, you have your compass, and we're heading due north here at the moment. You can see that there. Now, the wheel, these spokes here, turning to starboard, is turning to the right. And that's it now, Carrie. Come on, use a lot of effort in that now. Get it? Yeah, don't be afraid, turn, go back, get your back into it. Turn, bring her around. If the wind catches her now, you'll have to be able to do that twice as fast as you're doing at the moment.
Back in Dunleary now, did you enjoy your day?
Yeah.
And what was the best of all the days?
Controlling the ship.
Yeah, and what else?
That was all.
The crew were a bit mad though, weren't they?
Yeah.
What was the worst part?
When the ship was tipping over on the side.
Yeah, were you a bit scared?
Yeah.
And you looked a bit bothered too when you were trying to tie the ropes, didn't you?
Yeah.
Anyway, look what Captain Tom McCarthy gave to me to give to you. It's an Askar t-shirt, isn't it cool?
Yes.
It'll match your navy trunks. So look into the camera now and say, thanks, Tom.
Thanks, Tom.
Now when you're in the bath and your rubber ducky floats, remember the man from the past, Archimedes gets the vote.
Okay then, well done, Carl Fahey. Now, Captain Tom McCarthy told me to tell you all that unless you're over 16, you're not really allowed to go on board the Asgard, so don't write into him unless you are over 16. But thanks to Tom and to everybody on board the Asgard, give them all a cheer.
Yeah!
Okay, then now it's time to find out who's going to get the works next week. Lorraine Gunning wrote into us, and she's from Carrick and Shannon in County Leitrim. And we went to her house, but her mum said she was down here at the shops. Hello, Lorraine. Lorraine. Lorraine?
Oh, hi.
What do you want to do?
I want to be a journalist for a day, and I want to know how the papers are produced.
Well, we're going to bring you up here to Dublin, and you're going to spend the day with the Evening Herald. And if you're any use, you're going to get a story printed. Are you laughing?
I'm laughing.
Okay, we've reached the final round of our studio competition. As it stands, the scores are level pecking. 3 for the Greens, 3 for the Reds, but all could be won or lost in the final round because every single question correctly answered is worth a valuable iota. Let's see who goes first. Will it be the Reds? Will it be the Greens? This time it is a really, really definite advantage. Let's see. It's going to be the Red team.
Yeah!
Okay. And for the Reds, Ruth Ann and Aidan, your first question, your 2.5 minutes starts now. What do you call the condition that some people suffer from when there is too much pollen in the air?
Hay fever.
That's correct. You're on the board.
Okay, Peter and Owen, smiling away. What substance produced by flowering plants do bees feed on? No.
Nectar.
It's nectar, yeah, but you said it second, so I'm afraid you get nothing. You better stay where you are.
Okay, hard looking that. Ruth Ann and Aidan. The rice plant is a member of the grass family. True or false?
False.
It's true, I'm afraid. It is a member of the grass family. Hard luck on that.
Okay, then, Peter and Owen. In autumn, a tree sheds its leaves to stop it losing water. True or false?
False.
No, it's true.
No, they're tough ones. Ruth Ann, Aidan. Which of the following is produced directly from plants? Is it nylon, rubber, or plastic?
Nylon.
Nylon? No, it's rubber. Hard luck.
Oh my God, I don't believe this. Which of the following textiles is a natural fiber produced directly from plants? Is it polyester, cotton, or silk?
Cotton.
Take a step forward. Well done.
Okay, it's level pegging, Ruth Ann and Aidan. Which of these is responsible for the green colour in leaves? Is it A, sap, B, chlorophyll, or C, stomata?
B.
Chlorophyll is correct. Take a step forward.
Okay, then, Peter and Owen, which is the odd one out? Rosemary, basil, or rose?
Rose.
That is correct. The other two are herbs.
Okay, level pegging. Ruth Ann and Aidan, which of the following plants eats insects? Is it A, mandrake, B, lupic, or C, Venus flytrap?
Venus flytrap.
That's correct. Take a step forward.
Okay, then. Plants make their own food. This process is called A, fertilisation, B, photosynthesis, or C, corrosion.
Photosynthesis.
Correct. Take a step forward.
Okay, Ruth Ann and Aidan. What is the name of the study of plants and how they grow? The study of plants and how they grow. Have to hurry you.
Botany.
That's correct. Take a step forward.
Okay. Sugar. Sugar is produced from sugar beet. What other plants give us sugar? Come on, it grows in foreign... Sugar cane, yes, correct, it's a board.
Okay, Ruth Ann and Aidan. What is drawn from the roots to the tip of a plant by... I've started, so I'll finish. That's my favourite line. What is drawn from the roots of the tip of a plant by means of suction? Water is drawn from the roots of a plant to the tip of a plant by means of suction. This is called A, perspiration, B, transpiration, or C, evaporation.
Transpiration.
That's correct. Take a step forward.
This is close.
Okay. That means that the Reds win this round of the quiz. But does that mean the Reds have won the overall competition? We'll soon see when we add up the iotas. But let's take a look at the prizes that we have on offer to our competitors today. The runners-up will get a selection of Waddington board games, and the winners will receive from Philips a compact disc interactive machine, a television set, and some CDI discs, and it's absolutely fab!
Okay then, who are this week's winning team? Peter and Owen representing Dublin, place your bonus iotas, please.
Okay dudes, you have 3 iotas on the board. And you're plonking them all down there. You have a total of 7 for the Greens.
Well done.
Pretty good.
Okay, then, representing Cootill and County Cavan. Place your bonus iotas, please.
Okay, they had 3 already on the board. They did quite well on the quiz. That's 7.
Uh-huh.
And they've won more, which is 8 for the Reds.
Yeah! Megan Cavan, this week's winning team.
Okay.
Well done.
Well done to the Reds. Okay, that's it for the works for this week. We'll see you same time, same place next week. Keep your letters coming in. Until then, bye.
Bye. Time for the home question. The answer to the question before Christmas was, houseflies taste with their feet. Did you all guess that? No, it's strange but true, okay? So there's a prize on its way to Brian Kennedy from Kerr, County Tipperary, Carl Scott from Athlone in County Westmeath, and Sarah Sheil from Renmore in County Galway. That's the Waddington Make Your Own Candle set. And here with this week's question, help me along, is Nicola and Peter. Now with them there, they have cylinders and 2 oranges. Now watch what happens. Peter, to dump that in. See the way the whole mandarin floats, and dump that in there, Nicola. A peeled mandarin will sink to the bottom. Why does that happen? Well, Rory, what's this week's question?
Why does a whole orange stay afloat? Is it A, the skin contains trapped there which makes it buoyant, or B, because the orange has pips, or C, the heavier an object, the more likely it is to float?
That's right, Rory. Do you know what the answer is?
Yeah.
You do? Okay, keep it to yourself. Okay, then this is the question. Why does the whole mandarin stay afloat? Is it A, the skin contains trapped air which makes it buoyant? Is it because oranges have pips, or is it C, the heavier an object, the more likely it is to float? And there's going to be 3 winners next week, and each are going to receive a Waddington Blockbusters quiz game. So send your answers on a postcard to this address. The Works, RTE, Donnybrook, Dublin 4. That's The Works, RTE, Donnybrook, Dublin 4.
Please, Bob.
It's got to be said, The Words is a very, very, very brilliant program.
The Words is brilliant.
Because it's got lots of, it's kind of science.